The bulk modulus of the lead is 8 into 10 raised to 9 newton per meter square, and the initial density of the lead is 11.4 gram per centimeter cube. Then under the pressure of 2 into 10 raised to 8 newton per meter square, the density of the lead is. So let's check what is given to us. We have given the bulk modulus, we have given the initial density, and we have given the pressure. We have one formula, which is delta V equals to F V naught by AV. Using this formula, we can find the final volume of this cube, and also we can find the final density of this cube. So now, we don't have this F, we don't have this A. So from where to get it? There is no need of this F and A, because we know that F by A is your pressure, and pressure is actually given to you, which is 2 into 10 raised to 8 newton per meter square. So just substitute this F by A by this P, and we get that delta V equals to P V naught by V. So now just substitute the value of V and P, and what is this V naught? So in this figure you can see, before compression, the volume of this body is V naught, and after compression, the volume of this body is V dash. So, the value of P is 2 into 10 raised to 8, the value of V is 8 into 10 raised to 9. After solving the value of delta V, we get that delta V is your 1 by 40 V naught. So now, if we need the final volume, we would write V dash equals to V naught minus delta V. Now, there is a question, why this minus over here? Why not the plus? So the reason behind this is over here, that when we apply, see, here it is written, under the pressure of. So when we apply pressure to any body, the volume of that body decreases. Likewise, when we apply pressure, that green box, you can see this green box and this brown box. You can clearly see that the volume is decreasing because we have applied pressure from outside, and while applying this pressure, the volume will surely decrease. So due to decrease in volume, we have to put this minus sign over here, not the plus sign. Okay, so the final volume V dash you will get as V naught minus V naught by 40, which is 39 V naught by 40. So now you know the final volume, you know the initial volume. So now we just have to compare the densities, and to compare the densities we will use one concept of conservation of mass. Now why mass is conserved? Because by applying the pressure, the mass don't change. The thing which change is the volume and its density. So by applying the pressure, the mass won't change. So we would conserve the mass over here and find the value. Okay, so now here rho dash I have written. So rho dash is the final density which we have to find. So now, you know one thing, that mass upon volume is your density. So now if you knew the value of the mass, you can write that m equals to rho v. So just put m equals to rho v, which I have put it here. Rho naught V naught equals to rho dash V dash. That is, initial mass is your final mass. Okay, so we know the value of rho naught, we know the value of V naught, we also know the value of V dash, just we have to find this rho dash. So by calculating the value of rho dash, we get rho dash equals to approximately 11.7 gram per centimeter cube. I hope you have understood how this answer came. And also let's check, is it in the option? Yes, it is in the option, which is the D option. So D is your correct answer. One more method to use in this question, which is by substituting V naught as M by rho naught. Okay, from this equation, you can clearly see that V equals to M by rho. So by putting V naught equals to M by rho naught, you can also solve this question. But while solving this method, by this method, you will actually face many complications. method is consuming time, but this method won't consume your time and also give you the correct answer.